Introduction to jitter in clocks and bit error rate for various data rates. There are different applications which have different requirements of the same time accuracy and stability. For example, you have jitter in data converters. What is jitter? Jitter is the amount of input edge variation that gives an error in the output edge variation. What this means is, as the clock jitter affects the sampling point in a signal, the jitter impacts something called a measurement error, which we can attribute to either a quantization error or noise error, instrumentation error, or other generically mentioned measurement errors. Now, what this does is, this typically tries to increase the FFT noise floor. So what is an FFT noise floor? An FFT noise floor is the fast Fourier transform equivalent, where you convert a time domain information into a frequency domain information. And in this, you understand that the desired signal has got a very high amplitude, right? And the undesired signal is expected to have a very low amplitude. How do you cross-refer to the time domain signal? If the time domain signal in this particular case, the clock edge, has a fixed point, okay, where it is the expected fixed point, and there is no variation around it, that would equate to having a very high signal at that particular edge where it is present. Later, the difference in the variation gives rise to difference in frequency components around the signal of interest. Right? Now, if that signal of interest is reduced to a minimum in the band of interest, then that shows that the signal is very large compared to the noise. And this difference between the two powers is given as the signal to the noise ratio, or SNR. SNR is typically defined in a desired frequency band around which all the other frequency bands are kept as undesired or out of band. Likewise, you will see something similar happening in timing violations in digital systems. For example, the same clock edge that you see here, if the clock edge moves earlier, then the setup time will be longer and the hold time will be shorter. And if you move the time further away from the expected desired signal, then the setup time will be shorter and hold time will be further shorter. This will introduce setup hold time variations or distribution differences in the signal. So this is very critical in digital system, which can either cause faults or wrong error sampling, or bit will be sampled at various different clock instances, giving rise to a higher error in the number of bits. Now, how do you compensate that effect? And what is the metric that is used to understand the bit error system? That is given as bit error rate. What does bit error rate mean? The number of errors coming in the data transmission signal to the total number of bits that are being sent. That is given as bit error rate. Now, how do you define bit error rate mathematically? You can say, if there is one error for every 10 to the power of 10 bits sent, then that is called a bit error of 1 in 10 to the power of 10. It is written as BER, bit error is given as 1 into 10 to the power of minus 10. So that is a bit error rate defined. What does that represent? So 1 bit error for every 10 to the power of 10 bits transmitted. Similarly, to understand that more number of bits get transferred, so how, now what do this effectively mean? This effectively means that there is a 1 bit error in every 10 to the power of 9 is a giga and 10. So 1 bit error in every 10 gigabit of transfer, right? Now, this shows that your error is significant. But when you are looking at high volume data, the expectation, especially if you are working in the server domains where you are doing large data transfer in a server, the expectation is that you have the bit error rate as high as 10 to the power of 12 or 10 to the power of 15. In some cases, the bit error rate is defined as 1 to 10 to the power of minus 24 also, which shows there is a very high quality signal coming out and the error is very small compared to the other items. Crystal oscillators are XO. The X stands for crystal and O stands for oscillator. Crystal oscillators. To understand the importance of this signal, people have traditionally started using something called crystal oscillators, right? And these crystal oscillators are used for very demanding application. For example, the applications where BER is expected to be very high, of 10 to the power of minus 12 and above, right? So that is one bit error for every 10 to the power of 12 bits transferred. Now, what are the characteristics of these oscillators? Here, as you see, there are figures showing oscillators with 12 megahertz crystal oscillator, there is a 48 megahertz crystal oscillator, and there is a 12.8 megahertz crystal oscillator present. And each is having either two leads, one is a reference, one is the output, or you will have multiple leads, which could sometimes be support or information transmission presenting. Now, what are the characteristics of a crystal oscillator? Crystal oscillator has excellent stability, meaning it does not vary with increased temperature, right? Because there will be enough heat encapsulation or heat dissipating items. The variation will not differ with respect to time or what we call as age, right? Even if the time increases, the crystal oscillator does not vary its operation. And one of the other features it maintains is it is great for accurate frequency. When the system claims that it is 12 megahertz, the frequency is always maintained at that fixed value. It does not vary. The frequency is always maintained. So when you have critical operations where accurate frequency is desired, crystal oscillators are the preferred mode of information transfer. Now, but these come at a trade-off. What is the trade-off? The trade-off is there is a speed limitation. As you can see, the reference is seen at say 12 megahertz, 12.8 megahertz, 48 megahertz and others. The frequency can be as high as 100 megahertz, where you have crystal oscillators available. At most, sometimes you have seen, or practically we have seen, 125 megahertz signals being crystals being utilized in design. These are the maximum frequency are available, but they really come at a very high price. The cost is significant, because to maintain that kind of an oscillation and that kind of an accuracy and that kind of stability, you need to pay a cost. So the cost is very high and the price is very high. Now, how do you take the design forward for higher frequencies? You need to do some activity. What is that?